Hi everybody, welcome back to Kut Start with Mohammed Fathi. This is our YouTube channel. You can go to the playlists. You will see all the playlists. For example, the Flutter course will be divided into playlist. Each playlist will we will explain topics, certain topics. For example, in the Flutter navigation and routing, we will discuss all the topics related to the navigation and routing. And this playlist will contain all the videos related to the navigation and routing, the Flutter, for example, Flutter image widgets. This playlist will contain all the videos related to the Flutter image widgets. Please don't forget to share, subscribe, and click on the like button if you liked the video, and leave a comment here. It help us to improve the channel. Today we will continue talking about the Flutter routing. In the last lecture, we have talked about the bush named, bush replacement named, bush and remove until, bush named and remove until. I am gonna recap the two methods, push and remove until, push named and remove until. So let me open the VS Code. This is the last project I have created in the last lecture. So it contains three screens and the home screen. So if you click on this, the screen, it contains home screen one, screen two, screen three. So if you on the screen three, this is a screen three, and have a button, for example, this button, go to open screen two. Here I'm gonna go to the screen two using the navigator, navigator.ofcontext.push. There are two methods, push and remove until, push named and remove until. I'm gonna first use the push and remove until. The difference between push and remove until and push named and remove until, the first one, push and remove until will take a basic route or on the fly route, but push named and remove until will take a named route. For example, let me use the first one, this push and remove until. The first, I'm gonna here make a material page route, material page route. So inside the material page route, the builder will take a context, and it create an instance of the second screen or screen two. So and the predicate here, I'm gonna return false. Return false means, so it will anonymous function take a route, and it will here it will return false. So this means it will, let me save, this means it will remove all the screens from the stack until it go to the screen two. It will remove any screens from the stack. For example, let me open the draw.io. So this is a stack, and this is a screens, and this is the emulator. So let me open the screen. So this is the home screen, and now the stack contains the home screen. If you clicked on the open screen one, the screen one will be pushed onto the stack. If you click, let me minimize this. If you clicked on the open screen two, the screen two will be pushed into the stack. If you click on the open screen three, the screen three will be pushed into the stack. If you click back, it will remove the screen three from the stack. Now you are in the screen two. If you click back, the screen two will be popped from the stack. Now you are in the screen one, and the stack contains the screen one here. If you click back, also it will be removed from the stack, and now the stack only contain the home screen. If you click back, you will exit the app. So if you click open the screen one again, it will be screen one pushed to the stack. If you clicked open screen two, the screen two will be pushed into the stack. If you click open the screen three will be pushed into the stack. If you click go or open screen two, it will go to the screen two and remove all the screens from the stack because you are returning false. Returning false means you will remove all the screens or the widget from the stack until you go to the until you went to this or until you in the home screen. So let me open screen three. So I am gonna remove all the screens from the stack. Only the screen two will be screen two will be on the stack. So now the screen two, you are on the screen two. There is no back button. If you click back, you will exit the app like this. So it will be removed, nothing in the stack. So let me start the app another time. So this is a push and remove, push and remove until. You can also, instead of this route, you can make here model route dot with a name, and here for example you will leave the home. This means you will go to the you will go to the screen two and remove all the routes only the until you go to the route, the home routes. So let me save this and open the draw.io. So here the stack only contain the home screen. If you click on the open screen one, the screen one will be opened, pushed into the stack. Click open screen two, the screen two will be pushed into the stack. Click on the open screen three, the screen three will be pushed into the stack. If you click open screen two, you will remove, you will go to the screen two and remove all the screens from the stack. Only you will leave the home screen. So click go to screen two, so it will remove all the screen, only the home it will be exist on the stack. So if you now on on the, so let me try to start open screen. You are in screen two, so let me go to the here and open screen two. So so route with the home screen. So if you click this, so let me try to restart again. So now in the screen two and open screen two, navigator dot push and remove until material page route, it'll go to the screen two and here the route dot name. Okay, it will be, let me run another time. So I am gonna go to the screen two and remove all the widget until the home screen. So it will work fine. Let me, it will run syncing. So let me make this. And here the home screen, click open screen one. The screen one will be pushed here. Click open screen two, the screen two will be pushed here. So open screen three, the screen three will be pushed inside the screen three. If you clicked on the screen three, if you clicked on the open screen two, it will go to the screen two. So screen two, click open screen two. So now it will remove all the screen and only the screen two and the home. If you click back now, you will remove this and the home will be exist. So it's work fine. It's work fine. Everything is good. So this is a pushed and remove until. You can also use a push named and remove until. So the different named here, it will only take a named route. So I am gonna remove this. And here I am gonna pass a named route. Here the named route, for example, I am gonna go to the screen 2. So it also work fine. Let me restart the app. So here let me open the here I'm gonna, this is the home and this is the home screen. Click on the open screen one. The screen one will be pushed into the stack. If you click on the open screen 2, the screen 2 will be pushed to the stack. If you click on the open screen 3, the screen 3 will be pushed into the stack. If you click on the open screen 2, I am gonna remove every thing until you go to the screen 2 and leave the home only. So if you click now back, because it will remove the screen 2 and the home will be exist into the stack. So this is the means of the model route with the name. So let me talk about the pop. So you pop. So the pop means it will pop the screen from the stack. For example, let me open the VS Code here. And if you on the screen 3, why this is a screen 3. Oh, open the screen 3 and here let me make another button. And this button will for example contains a back. So navigator dot of context, let me remove all of this. So here the navigator dot of context dot pop pop, it will remove this from the stack and it will go back. We have discussed this in the previous lecture. Also we can use pop and push named. I'm gonna remove the screen 3 and push, for example. Let me make to be this clear. Let me go to the null, go to the screen for example 2 and make the button here control V, and this button will go to screen 3 for example, go to 3, and here I am gonna use the navigator dot pop and push. So let me make pop here. I am gonna remove the screen 2 and push instead of this, or replace with for example screen 3. So this will remove the current screen, all the screen 2 and push to the screen, current screen, the screen 2 and push to the screen 3. So let me save here in the screen 2, open this and open the draw.io. So this is the home screen and the home screen. If you go to the open screen 1, the screen 1 will be pushed here. If you click on the open second, the second will be pushed here. Now if you click in the go 3, so it will be remove this push and pop and push. So the code here pop and push named. So it will be pop the screen 2 and push the screen 3. So let me go here. So okay, you are on the screen 3. If you click back, you will be on the screen 2. So let me click back here. you will be on the screen one like this. If you click back another time, you will be on the home screen. I think it's clear. So this is a pop and push name. Pop, the difference between, let me click, for example, make a button here in the home screen. Let me go to the home screen. Let me make another button here. This is back. This is a screen, the home screen. Let me make this button back. So the home screen is the first screen in the stack. If you click the navigator dot pop, dot pop. So if you click this pop, let me restart the app and open the here. And so this is the emulator, the home screen, and you are back. So if you click on the back, you will pop this, you will remove this. So it will go to the home screen. It will be inside the home screen, and you are here, nothing in the stack. So you will pop this. I wanna to test if this the only screen on the stack. I am gonna use the mepub. If this is the only screen on the stack, I will not remove it. So because it's only the last one in the stack, so I am gonna use the let me restart this. So I am gonna use here me instead of pop, me pop, me pop, me be pop, me be pop. For example, try to pop the current route while running the routes. It will try. If this the only route on the stack, it will not remove it. So the difference between pub and maybe pub, it ask if this the only one, it will not remove, but pub it remove anyway. For example, it's only one screen on the stack, it's the last one in the stack, it will remove if using the pub. So let me go here, and this is the stack, this is the home, and this is the home. If you click back, it will why this me pop context. Let me restart it. Something wrong here. Navigator dot me pop. You should not remove the from the stack because this is the only one, and here I'm using the me pub. It will work fine. Let me restart the app and it will work fine. I'm waiting. Okay, it will be run. Yes. Okay. Syncing the file to the device. And if you click back now, this is the one. If you click back now, nothing. Yes, it's work fine. Nothing happened because I'm using the maybe pub. So this is the maybe pub. Pub until it will pop until you go to a certain screen. For example, let me go to the for example screen 3, and here you for example home and navigator dot of context dot pop until. So pop until predicate. You can go, for example, until model route, model route, and here dot with For example, for the slash, you will remove all the stack pop until you will pop all until you go to the home screen. You will be pop everything from the stack until you go to the home. Let me run restart to make sure it's work fine. This is the stack. This is the home screen. Open screen one. It will be open screen one. Push to the stack. Open screen two. The screen two will be pushed to the stack. Open screen three. The screen three will be pushed to the stack. If you click home, it will remove everything from the stack until pop everything from the stack until you are in the home. So this will work fine. There is no home, there is no back. If you click back here, nothing will happen because nothing in the stack. There is only the home screen. If you use here pop, it will remove this from the stack and the application will be exit. So this is the end of the lecture. Please don't forget to share, subscribe, and leave a comment underneath the video and like the video. See you.